Namaste children, welcome to social class. In our last session we studied about social reformers and the rise of nationalism.
In this video we study about the remaining topic in chapter 19, the struggle for independence. Our first topic is the partition of Bengal and the Swadeshi movement. What do you mean by the partition of Bengal and the Swadeshi movement? Let's see some points about that. Our first point, the British were worried about the growing feeling of nationalism among the Indians. They realized that if the people of India got united, they could easily throw the British out. To weaken the feeling of nationalism among Indians, the British tried to divide them on the basis of religion. They decided to divide Bengal into two parts, one for the Hindus and the other for the Muslims. In which year? In 1905. Our second point, the Indians protested strongly against the division of Bengal. The anger in the people gave rise to the Swadeshi movement. What do you mean by Swadeshi? Swadeshi means our own country. People pledged to use goods made in their own country and boycotted British goods. Bonfire of British goods, especially cloths. Women and students also participated in that movement. It spread in Bengal but soon spread to other parts of India. Our next point, the British tried to ruthlessly put down the movement. People were fined and mercilessly beaten. But ultimately, the opposition to the partition of Bengal was successful and the British were forced to reunite. Our next topic was activities of the revolutionaries. After the partition of Bengal, several young Indians started using more violent means to fight the British. They formed a group to fight the British and were willing to sacrifice their lives for the country. They are called the revolutionaries. Let's see some important revolutionaries. Aurobindo Ghosh, Barun Ghosh, Chandrasekhar Azad, Bhagat Singh, Sukhdev, Rajguru and Udham Singh. The movement, however, was not very successful. Our next topic, World War I and after. World War I broke out in the year 1914. Lakhs of Indian soldiers fought with the British army. Thousands were killed. Indians thought that the British would be more sympathetic towards them after the war. However, this did not happen. The British became even harsher towards Indians. They imposed fresh taxes to recover the losses they suffered in the war. You already know that Mahatma Gandhi came back to India from South Africa in the year 1915, while World War I was still going on. Let's recap. Social reformers fought against the evils that divided the Indian society and made it backward. Second point, the Indian National Congress was formed in 1885 by the educated people of India who were dissatisfied with the British rule. A third point, the Indian National Congress initially demanded reforms for Indians under the British rule. Fourth point, many congressmen did not like the soft approach of the leaders and wanted Swaraj or self-rule. Fifth one, to weaken the feeling of nationalism among Indians, the British tried to divide them on the basis of religion. Sixth one, the protest against the British division of Bengal led to the Swadeshi movement. Seventh point, the revolutionaries believed in fighting the British with arms. The British became harsher towards the Indians after World War I.
Thank you, children.